Beloved in Christ, at this Christmas time, let it be our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which has come to pass in the babe lying in a manger. Therefore, let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by His Holy Child. First, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill among all God's people, for unity and harmony within the church that Christ came to build, especially within this, our community. Because this would rejoice his heart, let us remember in Christ's name the poor and helpless, the cold, hungry, the oppressed, the sick, them that mourn, the lonely, the unloved, the aged, the little children, all those who know not the Lord Jesus or love him not, who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we are one forevermore. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven, in the words which Christ himself has taught us. Our Father.
A reading from the 9th chapter of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as men make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaker, you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For every boot that trampled in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for the flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this, the word of the Lord.
Centuries of sorrow. A reading from the 14th chapter of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort. Give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service is at an end. Her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in. Every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made a plain. The rough country, a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all humanity shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. I answer, what shall I cry out? All humanity is grass, and all their glory like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower wilts. And the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Though the grass withers and the flower wilts, the word of our God stands forever. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. But in coming to her, he said, "Hail, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you shall conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who is called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The word of the Lord.
And Joseph, too, went up from Galilee, from the town Nazareth, to to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David. He enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. The word of the Lord.
Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people, Israel. And Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The word of the Lord.
Thank you for coming. I certainly thank all of our musicians and lectors for helping us to pray this night. It is a great and wonderful gift that they offer and that we receive. But as we come together this night, come to reflect upon the dream, to reflect upon its fulfillment, and the new dream.
because we hear in the words of the prophet the great grace that God pours out in such abundance on humanity, calling us, desiring us, "You are precious in my eyes and glorious, and I have loved you." How many times do we hear that throughout our lives? Who says that to us? How marvelous that this is the word of God who has been spoken to us. But as we come together, we reflect upon primary symbols for us. And so we gaze upon the cross, and we carry in an infant. And when we reflect upon an infant, a child, we cannot but be touched by love. The helplessness of the child, the need that the child has, and the beauty that is simply a fact of life. And we gaze upon a child, and we see hope and a future, dreams and wonder. We see it manifested in love. We gaze upon the cross. And what is the cross for us if it is not the ultimate manifestation of the love that is God? A love that is poured out, that is given away. A marvelous love, the dream of a new world, the dream of a world that is at peace, the dream of a world where all of the diversity and all of the many ways of knowing and all of the many names or lack of names for the experience of God are respected and cherished. We dream of a world where gift is the reality. And it is not the gift of the powerful or the wealthy who stand back and give the gift to the poor. Because after all, this child was born in poverty. It is rather the gift that realizes mutuality. The gift that realizes that even as I give, I have received back more than I could ever possibly imagine. We dream of that world where we know this for ourselves, and it is not the taking care of the other. It is rather the entrance into the mystery of God that we discover in the other. And the entrance into this mystery is that mutuality of gift. Because God says, "I desire you. You are gift to me." And we, for our part, know that in the deepest longing of our heart, we desire the experience of God. The experience of God that is only known for us, the only power that God has, is love. So many times we want this powerful God to wipe away our enemies. But what does God do? God loves them. We have been loved into being, all of us, in such uniqueness and such wonder. Our primary symbols as Christian men and women, the child and the cross, are symbols of love. They are our only power, love. It is our dream to know this love. In Christ, it is our fulfillment to live in this love. And our dream continues as we, in mutuality, share that gift throughout the world.
Oh, Thank you.
Peace of the Lord be with you.
Amen.
Let us offer Christ's peace to one another. Let us pray. We give you praise and thanks, O God, that in wonder and beauty, in music and word, we contemplate the greatness of your love for us and the boundlessness of your goodness. We ask you that as you have placed in our hearts the dream of a new world, a world filled with that goodness and with that love, so may our lives reflect the dream we hold in our hearts, that all men and women may know the goodness and graciousness of your presence. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Before we go, I just want to a couple more things on your program, of course, but we also have some wonderful refreshments prepared by our Open Hearts Ministry next door afterwards, so I invite you to stop over.